On to our next speaker, Dr. Ratni Linian David, Consultant Glaucoma Services from Shankar Nethralaya, Chennai, to showcase her challenge. We look forward to seeing your video, Dr. Ratni.
Do you see my video, ma'am?
We see your desktop, actually. Can you click open your folder? Dr. Anand, can you show her video instead?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, because we are running short of time and we are good.
Now, can you see, ma'am?
Yes. Go ahead. Sorry. Go ahead. Yeah, you could start off. We don't hear you. Can you start talking?
1 minute, ma'am.
Dr. Ratni, your video is not playing properly. I think it has started now. Would you like me to play it from my side?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
I think you have a network problem. You can stop sharing. That will help your problem.
Okay.
In the meantime, I'll start from my end. I have two videos from you. Which one should I play first?
I think
of Sari Begum?
I could show the main video, Ratni.
Yes, ma'am.
One is of Sari Begum and the other, or if it's playing at your end, then...
The second one, Ratni, which one? The main one.
First one.
Ma'am, here. There is of Sari Begum and there is RLD02.
Not this one, the next one. You switch off your video, Dr. Ratni?
You stop sharing. Dr. Ratni, just stop sharing. I'll just interrupt your sharing. Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Actually, if you switch off your video, we may hear you, I think. I don't know, because there's some network issue.
Now, can you see my presentation, ma'am?
No. Let him show the... Dr. Anand, can you show her presentation? Could we see your second video? The one in which you are showing that capsule encapsulation.
Fine, ma'am?
Yeah. Can I speak, ma'am?
Yes.
Yeah, good evening. This was a patient with who had an eye syndrome, and he had had multiple surgeries done in the past, including AGV, which was functioning about 4 years post-surgery. Then when he presented to us, he had uncontrolled intraocular pressures with an encapsulated blip over the AGV plate. So there were two options in this case. One was to do a blip excision revision, and the other was to do a second drainage device. So we decided to go ahead and do a blip excision revision. So as you can see, the conjunctiva and the tenons are open, overlying the anterior aspect of the plate, parallel to the limbus, and then the layers of the capsule are carefully excised until we reach the cyst wall. Then a stab incision is made and a strip of tissue overlying the valve is excised, and the underlying AGV valve is exposed. Further, some more dissection is carried out to expose the anterior aspect of the plate and the valve. Then a paracentesis is made. And in order to re-establish the flow, VSS is injected into the anterior chamber. And we check for flow through the valve. As you can see, there is flow occurring through the valve. So then merosyl sponge is soaked in mitomycin C, about 0.4 milligram per ml, is placed under the residual fibrous capsule for about a minute. and the sponges are removed and the area is rinsed thoroughly. Then the tenons and conjunctiva are closed in separate layers. So this patient did okay for about 6 months after the glaucoma, the bleb excision revision. So bleb excision revision is a useful alternative in those eyes with severely scarred conjunctiva, and it's a simpler alternative to a second glaucoma drainage device.
You have time for the other video to be shown? Can you show the other video too?
The other patient was a patient who had you playing the video, ma'am?
Yeah, Mr. Dr. Anand? Can you play the first video?
Yeah, this patient had extracapsular cataract extraction without IOL implantation elsewhere, and she came with uncontrolled intraocular pressures. So we did done an inferior AGV for her, but on first post-op day, we found the inferior inferior tube to be blocked by vitreous. So we decided to clear the tube block surgically because the YAG vitreolysis was unsuccessful. So as you can see, an anterior vitrectomy is performed, and then the tube is held with a microforceps, and using a hydrocannula, the tube which is occluded by the vitreous is aspirated out, and it is completed by with the help of another microforceps, which is introduced into the tube, and the strand is pulled out, and the anterior vitrectomy is completed around the tube. And at the end of surgery, the AC is formed and there's no vitreous in AC, and the cornea has cleared up post-operatively. Patient did well, and her intraocular pressures were well controlled on one AGM. So in AFIC, sometimes we may have to do a complete vitrectomy when there is no history of previous vitrectomy, or when the iris diaphragm is not in good shape, then we might have to combine it with a complete pars plana vitrectomy to prevent tube occlusion with vitreous. Thank you, ma'am. I'm sorry about the video.
That's okay. I just one question to you. How many months after this did you have this kind of raised IOP after the primary surgery?
The in the eye syndrome, ma'am, after 4 years, the AGV was functioning well for 4 years. Thereafter, the pressure started to go up again.
So what would be the caution which you would advise when you are cutting the fibrous capsule for an ophthalmologist doing opening up an encapsulation as this?
The encapsulated, the bleb is really thick, ma'am. So it needs a 15 degree to make an incision to cut through the cyst walls. And it has to be done layer by layer until you finally reach the final cyst wall. It has to be done with a great care.
No, because you shouldn't end up damaging the casing of
the valve. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Murli, you have a question before you go on to the next speaker?
Yes, madam. I would like to ask this question to Dr. Ratni and Dr. Ganesh and Dr. Neetu. If this had been an RD, can you still use mitomycin C, and would you have to ligate the tube once this bleb excision is done, capsule excision is done, if this had been an RD instead of an AG?
No, if it had been an RD, I don't think we would have such a dense encapsulation. And of course, a late failure of RD is possible, in which you have a sudden fibrosis, and because of inflammation, the scarring does occur. So, but you don't have a thick capsule formation at that time. The conjunctiva just sticks to the RD and everything just flattens out. So there's no role of excising and reactivating that. You have to really plan for it in another position, another location.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Ganesh, for the